Welcome back to Jandor Plays Dragon Age Origins. This is my party playthrough of the game where I'll be using only Morrigan, Alistar, and the dog, the Mabari Hound, as my party members. Playing on Nightmare difficulty with none of the DLC items. The mod list I'm using is below in the description, but generally speaking it's mostly cosmetic mods and then the Fixpack that addresses some of the bugs that were left over after patch 1.04, which is the last one BioWare released. Back in, what, 2010 or something? Because, yeah, this game is about 7 years old. Still super good. So we've started. We are a Dalish Elf with the Dalish Elf background, Elven Rogue. And we've played through the first chunk of the background story. And now we're going to go run around the camp and collect stuff. Not possible to pick.
I shall do it.
So that we can sell it and make some cash and go about our business. The next thing we have to do is run back to this camp and meet up with Meryl. Meryl, who you might recognize if you played Dragon Age 2. What up, Huntress? Alright, hey, random woman.
I'm glad you survived. Losing two of our young would be a great blow to the clan.
You look more human than you do elven. One of the mods I've got is called Improved Atmosphere. Which adds like new items and other crazy stuff to the game. And then I've also got something called, like, what is Meryl wearing? What the hell? Dragon Age Redesigned. Oh, crap. And apparently Meryl's not wearing clothes. Don't ask me why. Let's check into that. There may be some odd bugs, you know, mods. That's how that goes. We'll find out. We're gonna click on all these little things first. One of the other weird bugs that I've got to address is that helmet. I don't seem to be able to wear a helmet, and I'm not sure why or how to fix that.
It is begun.
Because I very much need to be able to wear helmets. Helmets are good. And there are some good helmets. What's going on?
I'm glad you survived. Losing two of our young would be a great blow to the clan.
Wait, do you look like exactly like the other person? And here's a couple random people. Let's see if they have anything interesting to say.
Ah, it's good you're well. You weren't here when Paul arrived, were you?
I've heard of you. Everyone is talking about you and the other missing hunter. A Grey Warden brought you back here.
The hunter's name is Tamlin.
I hope you find him soon.
He's
Paul's a flat ear. He arrived here a few days ago from the human lands.
Flat ear?
I heard rumors in a nearby human village that a Dalish camp was close, and I hope to find your hunters in the forest.
You were fortunate I didn't shoot you, Paul. I thought you were a Shem, and a bandit at that. You're not the first city elf to rejoin his people. I'm sure you'll find life among us more satisfying than with the Shems, if no less harsh.
In the alienage, we hear terrible stories about the Dalish. They aren't true, right?
Let's see. Only the part where we sacrifice young elves to the gods.
That's funny. It is funny, right? You don't actually do that.
Gotta play a wise ass when you're playing a rogue. I mean, what's the point otherwise, yeah? Arlathan. Lots of good stuff in here. You pick up a lot of information, too. If you ever play through Dragon Age Inquisition, there is a lot of stuff about the elves in that game. Particularly Fen'Harral. Haha. Yeah.
Very well.
Particularly him.
As you say.
Dalish armor. There's another scroll here. You can see what I mean about Tab being your best buddy. Now the main reason I'm doing all this is because I used to get a ton of experience doing it. And it really does add up over time. Even if you don't actually want to read through all this stuff.
So you have returned to us, Dalen. We are grateful you're whole and well.
I'm glad to be here as well, Hakan.
So you should be. What were you two thinking, wandering into that cave without first coming to tell the Keeper?
Oh, for the love of... We wanted to see if there was anything to tell, Hakan.
Once you saw what was inside, you should have returned. But you kept exploring, didn't you?
I suppose your youth can be forgiven. Sadly, Tamlin pays the price.
Losing you would be a terrible crime, Dalen. You belong to more than just yourself. Or do you not remember?
Wait, what do you mean?
Let us tell these children of the fall of the Dales.
Oh boy.
You can honor me by sharing in the telling.
All right. Certainly.
Come then. Help me as I go along. Children, hear of the fall of the Dales. Hear the tale of what makes you Dalish. Would you care to begin, Dalen?
All right. Long ago, we were slaves to the humans.
Yes. Slaves to a terrible empire.
Still
the humans built on the darkest magic. When it fell, we became free. We built a homeland in the Dales, worshipping the creators, and rebuilding the culture and history we lost in our long years of slavery.
Yo, my boy is stacked. Look at that. Eight-pack for days. But the humans wouldn't let us.
They were resentful because we would not worship their gods and because we put our people first. Over the years, their nations grew cold toward the Dales. In their eyes, we were blasphemers and cruel tyrants.
But also great for festivals, we're told.
A war erupted. The humans invaded our homeland in the name of their one god, denouncing our sacrilegious nation. And so the Dales fell. They took our lands and dispersed our people, forcing us to live in their cities and abandon our gods. But many of us refused to relinquish our ways. We instead chose to scatter to the winds, wandering the lands.
Not to mention the Shemlin city smelled terrible.
All right, that's quite enough out of you. To survive and preserve our culture, the clans stay apart until the day the Elvenon have a homeland once more. We shall then return the old ways to those of our people who have lost them. We are the Dalish, keepers of the lost lore, walkers of the lonely path.
We are the last Elven. Never again shall we submit.
The oath of the Dales, and no smartmouth comment. Thank the creators for small mercies. I will let you get back to your tasks. I pray you find Tamlin quickly.
As do I. Did elves ever live in caves?
I've never heard of such a thing. But in the days of ancient Arlathan, we lived free and spread far across the continent. We were as varied as the Shemlin, though fewer in number. Perhaps some of us lived in caves then, but all knowledge from that era is lost.
I should go.
Of course. May the gods guide your path, Dalen.
Now, if you guys are playing through this and you're interested, definitely good to talk to a lot of these guys because you can pick up a lot of cool information and, like, read through all of these fun, like, codex entries and all that good stuff. The Mother of the Hala, yep. You can get some cool stuff that way.
Have you fully recovered? I heard the keeper was confounded.
So I'm pretty sure I've gotten everything. Let's do a quick save and then talk to Meryl.
The keeper told me I'm to accompany you back to those caves. As her apprentice, I may see something you missed. But our main objective is to find Tamlin, of course.
Still not sure why.
We must make haste. He may not have much time.
Not wearing... I need supplies.
Master Aylan could help you, but do not tarry.
Okay, so what I need is clothes for you. I'm not sure why you're naked, but we go take care of that. Also make sure that I have some stuff. I might keep some of these items, but probably not, to be honest. It doesn't really matter. Where is... There it is.
I'm glad you've recovered. Once we find Tamlin, we can concentrate on the journey northward.
Thank you for the bow, Master Aylan. It is light and sturdy,
yeah, that bow is
much
sick.
Better than the one I made last year.
You are more than welcome. My father made it and used it in battle against the Klain tribes.
I will carry it with honor.
Could I ask you for a bow as well?
One of my own crafting, perhaps?
Yes, thank you. Persuade. So good.
It may not have a history, but you'll provide one for it soon enough, yes?
You have no idea. Why would you give away your father's bow?
We are all the same clan. His hand is as my hand. I have relinquished nothing. It was my father who first spoke of the Vir Tanadol, the three ways of the hunter. The first is the Vir Asan, the way of the arrow. to reach for our goal unrelenting. Mm. The second is the Vir Borasan, the way of the bow, to bend, but not to break. Mm. The last is the Vir Adelen, the way of the wood. We are as ancient as the forests, each tree a part of the greater land.
Word.
All Dalish are united in this. One day, we shall have a homeland again.
May I see your crafts?
Of course. Take whatever you need.
Yeah, we're going to be selling a lot of stuff. So there's a lot of crap I don't need. Like, basically all of this. Equipped, yeah. Ding, ding, ding. Dharmasan. It's a longsword. Short bow. Illins, there we go. Hey. We'll probably sell that. I might keep these elf flight arrows in case there's some really nasty stuff going on. Improves backstabs. Oh, hello. Those are good, but we don't need them because we're not using them. Don't need splint mail. Don't need Dalish armor because the other stuff we've got is better. So there you go. Now we've got a lot of crap, which is nice. Now, if I take a look at my items here. So the scout's bow, which is actually a pretty good rapid aim, is nice, but this is much better. Much, much better. So we're going to actually sell the scout's bow.
Back again?
Actually, no. I'm going to keep it.
May the creators guide your path.
I can give it to Alistar. Because it's one of the other things I like to do is I like to have everybody... And this is one of the things that kind of I roll my eyes about with the later versions of Dragon Age, is like you can't have multiple weapons. I find it pretty handy sometimes to be able to give every character a ranged weapon as well as a melee weapon, so that in circumstances where, like, you know, you're engaging at a great distance, you actually can engage at a great distance. I'm still really confused as to why Meryl's naked.
You're back. Are you ready to go now?
Aren't you worried about getting sick?
A little, but the Keeper cured you. How dangerous could it be? Even if I get sick, finding Tamlin or something valuable will be worth it.
I mean...
Enough to pique my interest and my concern. You can explain the rest on the way.
All right, let's go.
And let us make haste while daylight lasts.
So now I got a mage to play around with. And, you know, spoiler alert, Meryl does find something here. Okay, seriously, though, why do you not have clothes? I'm very, very confused as to why she doesn't have robes. or any kind of outfit. Silver leaf... That's really good. Dalish pendant, that's also real good. We are going to take both of those from you. Sylvan's Mercy, that's pretty nice little item there. So I'm taking these and equipping them. I honestly can't remember. I feel like those items are added in Improved Atmosphere because I don't remember them being the case, but oh. Well, there's some Darkspawn, all right. So, Meryl.
For the gales!
Don't give them the advantage!
There you go. Let's each of us attack. Oh my gosh.
I shall do it.
This is outrageous. Like I said, so engaging from a distance like this, like we can just take them out
quick.
From way back here instead of having
what
to
go and
fight them.
Were those Darkspawn?
Especially since Darkspawn. I don't know.
I've never seen anything like them. You can smell the evil on them. Where did they come from? Were they here before?
Maybe they follow the Grey... Maybe the mirror has something to do... Maybe they follow the Grey Warden here.
Or he followed them. But why would they come here? And why would he? Well, we'll find out soon enough. Let's hope we don't find any more of these monsters.
Let's hope we find
before
some
we go,
pants.
Are you all right? Were you hurt during the fight?
I'm fine. Why do you ask?
It's just that you're quite pale. You look a bit feverish, in fact.
What are you implying?
Nothing. Forget I said anything. Let's go.
What she's implying is that I am tainted. Which, actually, you might end up becoming tainted. I forget. This backstory, you might actually become tainted and have to become a Grey Warden as a means of maybe resisting it. Since that's the whole Grey Warden thing.
I wonder whose camp this is.
Oh my god.
Do you remember it being here?
Maybe it belongs to the Shimlin who found me.
You're probably right. Didn't he say he was headed back to the cave? If so, he's not here now. And we've seen no sign of Tamlin. Maybe we should... Wait. Do you hear that?
No forest creatures. Too quiet.
Exactly. The forest is too... still. Something's in the air. Something unnatural.
I don't like this.
It seems whatever you woke up inside that cave has spread outside. The sooner we find this cave and Tamlin, the sooner we can leave. Take us there quickly.
Yeah, I mean, that's what I was literally in the process of doing. Thank you very much. We're going to adjust your tactics real quick. So, enemy, target of party member, main character, arcane bolts. Enemy, target of party member, main character, attack. And we will shift like this. And there you go. This way.
Very well.
So one of the things that below the belt you'll notice gives penalties to defense and movement speed unless the target passes a physical resistance check. So you've got some resistances, right? And we'll go, so let me go into this real quick. So mental resistance, physical resistance, basically when you get hit with certain abilities, you check against these resistances. If you succeed in check, you resist.
I will make this quick.
If not, you are affected. Pretty straightforward. Math, not so straightforward, but higher is better. So we're blocked. It's another weird thing that sometimes happens. So we're going to move. We're going to have you move because where you're standing, you can't actually hit anything. Oh my god. You.
Quickly, we must fight!
Finally. Now, below the belt reduces defense, which obviously makes things easier to hit. And there's a formula you can find online, like the Dragon Age wikis and stuff. Like, when you get, you're comparing your attack and your defense scores, and like, one of the things that I'm going to do with this build, my goal is use offensive fire as an archer to get my defense like really high, like over 100, because at that point, basically you're unhittable, or very close to unhittable, which is pretty awesome. So we're going to kind of try that out. So high defense is good. And then armor. So defense protects you from being hit. Resistances protects you against effects. And armor protects you against damage. All very straightforward. This game kind of obscures some of the greater mechanics. Like you have armor of 8. Doesn't tell you exactly how much that resists or what the specifics are, but there's like, you know, certain weapons have armor penetration ratings, which reduce your
ruins.
Weapon and
interesting
armor and all that good stuff.
They're definitely of human origin, yet elven artifacts are scattered amongst them. Nothing explains the monsters, though.
Yeah, no,
but
I
we
know.
Must find Tamlin, or what's left of him. I can't imagine he's still alive with those creatures about.
Yeah, maybe they took him hostage.
Maybe. Let's just hope he's here, somewhere.
Which, not for nothing, when it comes to Darkspawn, is probably the worst possible outcome. So we're gonna zoom in, since we've already been through this. This is a handy way of BioWare reusing maps, as we all know BioWare likes to do. Not that I'm gonna begrudge them in this particular instance. Oh, and we see some dead Darkspawn, so that tells us that Duncan's been through here.
As you say.
Get off!
Don't give them the advantage!
Now you notice how when she's attacking, her damage color is green. That's because stabs. I think that affected him. Hard to tell.
For the tails! I will make this quick.
About the counter. That green means it's doing not. So white is physical damage. Green in this case, I believe, is nature damage. Iron bark? Yeah, nature damage, I think. Not sure why it's not telling me what type of damage it's dealing, but I'm pretty sure it's nature damage. And like certain creatures are resistant or immune to elemental damage, and then physical damage is reduced by elemental armor. Magical stabs and the like aren't reduced by armor, but they also deal pretty low damage overall. Unless you have like really high spell power and a couple of the talents that'll boost the raw numbers. So I'm gonna run through this whole cave again, just on the off chance that there's more darkspawn over here, because I want to get that experience, yo.
For the tails!
And you can see that with that tactic in place, Meryl is automatically firing away. Now, I could have her using, like, Arcane Bolt and some other stuff, which might speed things along, but ultimately, whatever. There we go.
Come! Let us end this!
Actually, we're going to attack this guy. All right, Meryl, you're going to... Whoa, you got all kinds of powers. Holy crap, I should have looked first. So Meryl's got some fun spells. And then you're going to go and back to attacking, and you're going to switch back to a bow. And you're going to be stunned. And I'm then going to try to show weakness that guy.
I must maintain!
There you go. See? Mages. Mages are super good. Should have checked that earlier. Speeds things along. Can I? Still can't crack it. That's a shame. Whoa! Can't climb over that. So around we go. Around and around and around we go, friends. Now, I got flaming weapons. So what flaming weapons does... there's a formula for this. You can see the description just says melee weapons. Wait, melee weapons of flame. Does this affect? Let me check. I'm not sure. It says it doesn't affect ranged. It does not affect ranged weapons, so it's of limited less utility. And it says I'm not using fire, but there's a formula. Damn it, Meryl! How did I not detect that trap either? Oh boy, alright, so we're gonna actually do this. We are gonna back the hell off because that is a mage. Mages are bad news. Meryl is currently engaged.
Have you no concern for your own existence?
Knock out. Alright, this is what we're gonna do, Meryl. You're going to drop some fire. You're going to drop some fire. Oh god, you're going to drink a poultice, because he just hit you with drain life, and that's not, it's not nice. So what is the weakness? Penalty to attack and defense, reduce strength. Which is fine, because that will help him hit, and yeah, I'm fine right now. Man, she saved me a lot of damage, huh? This is what I mean about having to play around with threat. Because if you don't have somebody that's good at generating threat, your mages start to take a lot of damage. You don't want your mages taking a lot of damage. If you could otherwise evolve, would it?
No quarter shall be given!
But we've hit level 3. Good, and now we can move on. My rule of thumb is always kill mages first. And then usually what I do is I usually take out the chaff before I go for the bigger heavy targets, like elites and bosses. I go for like the normal guys, except of course when mages are involved, because mages are super, super dangerous. And the main reason I do that is, like I talked about in video one, a dead enemy is an enemy that can't hurt you. So even though an elite is theoretically a greater threat, 5 or 6 normals are probably more of a threat than one elite. So if you can take them out, because you can usually take them out much faster, the overall threat of the encounter decreases. And that gives you more time to focus on the big guy where you're not getting, like, ankle bit to death, basically. So let's go ahead and check my level up. So we're done with strength. We should be done with strength for now. So we're going to keep pumping dexterity. We're going to... So we can't boost this yet, which is a shame. So I'm actually going to hold that until I get a skill point to put into improved combat training. And here's Dunkerino, my boy, my man, my main G, my OG.
So you were the one fighting Darkspawn. I thought I heard combat.
You're
Thanks
the elf
helping,
I
found
bro.
Wandering the forest, aren't you? I'm surprised you have recovered.
If you heard the fighting, why didn't you help?
I would have, had I not been battling them myself. Not all the kills here were yours, as you can see. My name is Duncan, and it's a pleasure to finally meet you. Mm. The last time we spoke, you were barely conscious.
And Daran Atishan,
oh
Duncan
God,
of the Grey Warden.
Why do you not have clothes?
I am Meryl,
camel
toe. Keeper's apprentice.
Your keeper did not send you after me, did she? I told her I would be in no danger.
We're looking for our brother Tamlin.
So you and your friend Tamlin both entered this cave, and you saw this mirror.
Yeah, Tamlin touched... Wait, you found some trace of him?
No, nor do I think I will. The Grey Wardens have seen artifacts like this mirror before. It is Tevinter in origin, used for communication. Over time, some of them simply break. They become filled with the same taint as the Darkspawn.
Interesting.
Tamlin's touch must have released it. It's what made you sick. And Tamlin too, I presume.
And we should destroy it. So it's true, I had the Darkspawn plague.
You have it still. And it will infect others so long as this mirror exists. Your recovery is only temporary. I can sense the sickness in you, and it is spreading. Look inside yourself, and you will see.
Yo, Duncan. Come on, man. Come on. Then what? Perhaps there is something to what you say.
Confirm it with your keeper later if you like. For now, we must deal with the mirror. It is a danger.
Yo, he's the best. So polite. Also straight up, he's like, yo, magic mirror, fuck you. I got a sword. And the mirror's like, I mean, yeah, I'm a mirror. What do you expect?
It is done. Now let's leave this cursed place. I must speak with the keeper immediately regarding your cure.
Wait, hold on. What about Tamlin?
There is nothing we can do.
What, so he's dead then? Are you sure?
Let me be very clear. There is nothing you can do for him. He's been tainted for 3 days now, unaided. Through your keeper's healing arts and your own willpower, you did not die. But Tamlin has no chance. Trust me when I say that he is gone. Now we should return.
Yo, won't there at least be a body?
The Darkspawn would have taken it.
Taken it where? What would they do with him?
Darkspawn are evil creatures, and it's best to leave it at that. I'm sorry.
Well, why not just tell me what the cure is?
It's not that simple. I would tell you more, but I must first speak with your keeper.
Very well. Let's go back to the camp.
I sense no other Darkspawn nearby, so it's safe. Lead on.
I'm relieved you have returned, and I did not expect to see you again so soon, Duncan.
I was not expecting to return so soon either, Keeper.
Dare I ask of Tamlin? What did you find of him?
The Grey Warden says we will find nothing.
I see. Meryl, what about the mirror? Did you bring anything back?
I can answer that, Keeper. I destroyed the mirror.
I intended to use it to find a cure for this mysterious illness. I trust you had good reasons for your actions.
There is much to discuss, Keeper. I have learned a great deal since I was last here.
Let us speak privately within my Aravel, then, Duncan. Meryl, warn the hunters. If Darkspawn are about, I want the clan prepared.
Manuvinen, Keeper. Right away.
Yalen,
get some pants.
Allow me some time to speak with Duncan. Seek us out at my Aravel later, and we can discuss your cure.
Okay, very well.
Tell Harren Pyvel what has occurred. He now has the sad task of preparing a service for the dead. Follow me, Duncan. I'm eager to hear what you have to say.
Oy, man. These origin stories are all, like, super grim. They really do a good job of, stamina draw. What the hell? Wait. I didn't think those were... Whatever. Pavel. Is there anybody else worth talking to?
I'm so glad everyone made it back safely.
Except,
even
like,
if that human is back here.
Whatever.
I wish we'd had more time to examine those artifacts.
Yeah, well, I know you took the freaking mirror pieces,
so... I see you have not returned with young Tamlin. Are we to assume the worst?
The Grey Warden says he will not be found.
A sad day for our clan. I know you and Tamlin were friends. My condolences on your loss.
Thank you.
May the creators guide your path.
Yo, can I see your shit?
Back again? Of
course. Real quick, just sell that. Alright. Get a little extra treasure. Try to free up space, make sure. Because it's like, pick up everything. It's always good to kind of free up space whenever possible. Alright, we gotta talk to my boy here. What up?
So you return with the Grey Warden, but without Tamlin. What happened, Dalen? Is he truly lost to us?
The Grey Warden says he is, but I am not sure.
Even if he's not, we must leave soon. To think I'd live to see this. It seems the will of the creators that I sing the dirge for those I held in my arms as babes. I think I know why our immortal ancestors would sleep. Swiftly do stars burn a path across the sky, hastening to place one last kiss upon your eye. Tenderly land enfolds you in slumber, softening the rolling thunder. Dagger now sheathed, bow no longer tense. During this, your last hour, only silence.
I don't recognize that poem.
Our ancestors did not age as we do. The Shemlin brought a quickening to our blood that changed us forever. Instead of death, those weary of life would pass into Uthanera, the waking slumber. In doing this, they made way for the young. It was supposed to be a beautiful time, a celebration of the elder's long life and contribution to his people. Alas, we have no such ceremonies these days.
Will you prepare a service for Tamlin, please?
Of course. We've no body to return to the soil, but we shall still sing for Tamlin. The creators must come to guide him to the beyond. Tell the Keeper, it shall be done before the clan is ready to move on.
Thank you, Haran.
I ask only one thing, if I may. This Grey Warden. You have met him now, yes? Is he a good man?
I truly cannot tell.
Interesting. What is it he talks to the Keeper about, I wonder? Perhaps you should go and ask.
I should go.
Of course. May the gods guide your path, Dalen.
Yep. So, Duncan, who... So, just for the record, White means a normal dude, yellow names are elites, and then red names are bosses. If you see somebody with a red name, it means they are some serious shit.
Your Keeper and I have spoken, and we've come to an arrangement that concerns you.
Okay.
My order is in need of help. You are in need of a cure. When I leave, I hope you will join me. You would make an excellent Grey Warden.
Hey, wait, Am I to become a Grey Warden Keeper?
Yes, Dalen. Your life depends on it.
The darkspawn taint courses through your veins. That you recovered at all is remarkable. But eventually the taint will sicken and kill you, or worse. The Grey Wardens can prevent that. But it means joining us.
I will not join out of pity.
This is not simply charity on my part. I would not offer this if I did not think you had the makings of a Grey Warden. Let me be clear. You will likely never return here. We go to fight the Darkspawn, a battle that will take us far from your clan.
Oh, good.
But we need you and others like you.
Is the clan sending me away?
A great army of Darkspawn gathers in the south. A new blight threatens the land. We cannot outrun this storm. Long ago, the Dalish agreed to aid the Grey Wardens against a blight should that day arrive. We must honor that agreement. It breaks my heart to send you away. As it would to watch you die slowly from this sickness. This is your duty and your salvation.
If this is my duty, then I will...
I welcome you to the Order. It is rare to have a Dalish amongst us, but they have always served with distinction.
I know you'll do your clan proud, Dalen. Take this ring. It is your heritage, and will protect you against the darkness to come.
A valuable gift. So, are you ready to go?
I would like to stay for Tamlin's funeral.
We have much ground to cover, but I cannot deny you that. Say your farewells. Then we must be off.
Come then, Dalen. Before the creators guide you from us, let your clan embrace you one last time.
I'm not sure if there's a cutscene here or not. Yo, that elven armor looks dope. Meryl, put some pants on. Okay, well...
We will be traveling south through the hinterlands to the ruin of Ostagar, on the edges of the Korkari Wilds. The Tevinter Imperium built Ostagar long ago to prevent the Wilders from invading the northern lowlands. It's fitting we make our stand here, even if we face a different foe within that forest. The King's forces have clashed with the Darkspawn several times. But here is where the bulk of the Horde will show itself. There are only a few Grey Wardens within Ferelden at the moment, but all of us are here. This blight must be stopped, here and now. If it spreads to the north, Ferelden will fall.
Ho there, Duncan.
Cheerful.
King Kaelan. I didn't expect a...
a royal welcome?
Dope.
I was beginning to worry you'd miss all the fun.
Not if I could help it, Your Majesty.
Then I'll have the mighty Duncan at my side in battle after all. Glorious.
Okay.
The other wardens told me you'd found a promising recruit. I take it this is he?
Allow me to introduce you, Your Majesty.
There's no need to be so formal, Duncan. We'll be shedding blood together after all. Ho there, friend. Might I know your name?
Go, Kaelan. You are that quintessential, like, good-hearted idiot king. I am no friend of yours, human lord. May I know your name? I highly doubt it, but anything is possible.
You've got yourself a lively one, Duncan. And I was beginning to think the wardens were all stodgy priests. You are Dalish, are you not? I hear your people possess remarkable skill and honor.
I thought the humans considered us dangerous vagrants.
To be fair, your people can be a bit standoffish. Not that I blame them, of course. I tell you this, you are very welcome here. The Grey Wardens will benefit greatly with you amongst them. I'm sorry to cut this short, but I should return to my tent. Loghain waits eagerly to bore me with his strategies.
Your uncle sends his greetings and reminds you that Redcliff forces could be here in less than a week.
Ha! Eamon just wants in on the glory. We've won 3 battles against these monsters, and tomorrow should be no different.
Wait, you sound very confident of that.
Overconfident, some would say. Right, Duncan?
Your Majesty, I'm not certain the Blight can be ended quite as quickly as you might wish.
I'm not even sure this is a true Blight. There are plenty of Darkspawn on the field, but alas, we've seen no sign of an archdemon.
Alas.
Disappointed, Your Majesty?
I'd hoped for a war like in the tales. You know, a king riding with the fabled Grey Wardens against a tainted god. But I suppose this will have to do.
So naive.
I must go before Loghain sends out a search party. Farewell, Grey Wardens.
It's weird, too, because Kaelan's, like, super naive, but also just, like, mans up and fucking murders himself in Darkspawn.
What the king said is true. They've won several battles against the Darkspawn here.
You don't sound very... He doesn't seem to take the Darkspawn very seriously.
True. Despite the victory so far, the Darkspawn horde grows larger with each passing day. By now, they look to outnumber us. I know there is an archdemon behind this, but I cannot ask the king to act solely on my feeling.
Why not? He seems to regard the Grey Wardens highly.
Yet not enough to wait for reinforcements from the Grey Wardens of Orlais. He believes our legend alone makes him invulnerable. Our numbers in Ferelden are too few. We must do what we can and look to Terran Loghain to make up the difference. To that end, we should proceed with the joining ritual without delay.
The who's at the what now?
Every recruit must go through a secret ritual we call the joining in order to become a Grey Warden.
That's not suspicious.
The joining is what will cure you of the suffering your tainted blood surely brings you. If it had been possible, I would have done it before now.
Why is this ritual so secret?
The joining is dangerous. I cannot speak more of it except to say that you will learn all in good time. Until then, you must trust that what is done is necessary.
Reassuring. Real reassuring. Let's get this over with then.
Feel free to explore the camp here as you wish. All I ask is that you do not leave it for the time being. There is another Grey Warden in the camp by the name of Alistar.
My man,
ready,
my boy.
Seek him out and tell him it's time to summon the other recruits. Until then, I have business I must attend to. You may find me at the Grey Warden tent on the other side of this bridge, should you need to.
Thanks, Hoss. Yo, but for real though, Duncan is the OG. Where are we going? Level 3. It should be level 4. I think some of the backstories you end up at level 4, and I guess some of them you end up like halfway to level 4 or whatever. It's not super, super consistent. It doesn't super matter either. Like, it's not the end of the world by any stretch. And I can make up some of this by picking locks. I'll be able to pickpockets later. You know, it's funny. I've never actually taken stealing this early. I wonder if it would be useful.
Make a watch over you, my lord.
Because usually there's other, like, combat training and stuff that's more important, or I really like coercion a lot, like...
Make a watch over you, my lord.
Because there's a lot of really cool things you can do with dialogue options, and I like having that, especially when, I mean, your cunning is going to be high anyway. The way coercion works basically is like, there's a, it's intimidating or coercion, and the persuasion skill is you do both, and there's like thresholds, and I want to say each time you put a rank in it, you get like 25 points basically. And it adds to your cunning or strength score depending on what you're trying to do. And so, theoretically, it is possible to, like, not need full ranks in it. But generally speaking, you get enough skill points that it's not a big deal just to take it to 4 and call it a day. There are also certain dialogue options where, like, it'll just say, like, hey, your cunning's really high, so you get to do this thing. We're going to be going to the Tower of Ishael later, for those of you that don't already know that. Which, given how long it's been since this game came out, I imagine most of you watching probably do. Although, who can say? But for right now, I mean, look at this place. Just look how cool this is. Like, they do such a good job with, like, these big scenic sort of ruins. It's just awesome. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to come here to the middle. We're going to take a quick look out over this bridge because it's dope. And we are going to wrap up this video here. And next time, we will continue into the camp and do some exploring, gain some items, run a couple side quests, meet some people, and then head out into the Kakari Wilds. Thank you for watching. This has been Jandor Plays Dragon Age Origins.